Okay, and I think we're back alive. All right, let's go ahead and resume.
There's the graveyard where my mother's buried.
Oh.
Where are you going?
Come on.
What are we looking for?
Was that open before? Creepy.
Your mother's grave.
They have her preserved in the airtight chamber. Her fingerprints will get us into Comstock House.
She's your mother.
The mother who abandons their child doesn't draw a lot of sympathy in my book.
Take a moment to think about what you're doing.
There. Do you open the door or do I have to go in with her?
Elizabeth.
It's her. How are you, Mother? Locked up in there, huh? Looks like you and I have some common ground.
Let me.
No.
Let me.
Look on the other side.
Elizabeth, why is your mother a ghost?
She's not. He used me to power that device. He opened up some kind of tear.
Ooh.
What is she? Alive or dead?
Why do you ask what?
When the delicious question is when.
The only difference between past and present
is semantics.
Lives, lived, will live.
Dies, died, will die.
If we could perceive time as it truly was,
what reason would grammar professors have to get out of bed?
Like us all, Lady Comstock exists across time.
She's both alive and dead.
She perceives being both.
She finds this condition disagreeable.
Perception without comprehension
is a dangerous combination. Look! Footsteps! She has to unfinished business.
We have to follow her. Convince her to open the gate to Comstock House.
It's a shame you have need of her to enter Comstock House.
Frankly, she doesn't seem all that cooperative.
There is a way to bring her to reason.
Three truths you must discover first.
Truths which, in this world, Comstock has destroyed.
If only one of you had the power to alter time and space.
That would be a blessing, wouldn't it?
Well, they're sarcastic.
There's something off about Lady Comstock.
Yeah. I noticed.
No, you don't understand. She doesn't belong here. I brought something through. I'm not so sure it was her.
Some ammo. Oh. That's right, it is over there. Okay. I'm sorry, what and where? Oh god. I am in a real bad spot. First.
Go ahead.
On it.
Dang it.
Need money? Okay.
No, I need a different vending machine.
Fancy putting those lock picking skills to work?
That won't take but a minute. Ready.
Oh. Finally putting that money to use.
I took your funeral photo.
Yes, I made an absolute hash of it.
One doesn't expect a picture of one's cause.
To come across so lifelessly.
What did you mean before when you said Lady Comstock didn't belong here?
Dang it.
She's almost feral. It's like she's a reflection. I don't know.
They've been dead these 7 days.
Okay. What?
That's insanity. What proof would you have that Mr. Fink would hurt the Lutesses?
The Lutesses told me.
The Lutesses? When?
Yesterday. Yesterday morning.
Rupert! They've been dead these 7 days.
Dun dun dun. Oh.
Some money. Want it?
All right.
No mercy! Turn it down!
Yikes!
Take this for the meeting.
Yes, thank you.
Get after him!
Take cover!
Oh wait, why am I?
Go ahead.
Sure thing.
Oh wait, yeah. Though. Sorry, what was that? Not yet. Let me figure out what that other place was first.
Can you help me out with this lock?
Oh, this won't take long at all. There.
Locked.
Sure thing. Code book. I don't know what a cipher is.
Locked. Elizabeth?
No problem.
Glitchy.
Help me out with this lock.
Child's play. All yours.
Nice.
Found some money. Take this.
Thank you.
there!
Fancy putting those lock-picking skills to work?
Got it.
There's just way too many things to check in this game. Yes.
Out with this lock?
That won't take but a minute. It's done.
This is another one.
Lady Comstock.
Dang it.
I think she's a combination of herself and my feelings towards her.
What do you mean?
I'm just so angry at her and at my father. I think she's her, but she's also partly me. I'm not even sure I understand it myself.
You done? No.
Lady Comstock seems to believe the child is a result of some errant act of carnality between myself and her beloved prophet. I told the poor woman the truth, that the child was a product of our little contraption, but I think she found that less believable than her delusion.
Ah!
Comstock seems to have been made sterile by simple exposure to our contraption. A theory. Just as sexual reproduction can de-emphasize the traits of each parent, so goes the effect of multiple realities on our own. Your traits dissipate until they become unrecognizable or cease to exist. Comstock seems to have been made sterile by simple exposure to our... Comstock has sabotaged our contraption. Yet, we are not dead. A theory. We are scattered amongst the possibilities. But my brother and I are together, and so I'm content. He is not. The business with the girl lies unresolved. But perhaps there is one who can finish it in our stead.
Did I even come over here at all? Or? Watch out for the fire. Oh, that's right, ammo. Okay, creepy elevator time. Get in here. Don't want you glitching out on me again. Ooh, perfect timing. Alright, for those not watching live, I'll see you in the next episode. Chat to you, signing out.